In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Grace and peace of God our Father, who raised Jesus from the dead, be with you always. In the waters of baptism, Inez died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May she now share with him eternal glory. In baptism, Inez received the sign of the cross. May she now share in Christ's victory over sin and death. Who have set a limit to this present life so as to open up an entry into eternity. We humbly beseech you that by the grace of your mercy, you may command the name of your servant Inez to be inscribed in the book of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated for our scriptures.
A reading from the book of the prophet Zephaniah. Shout out for joy, O daughter Zion. Sing joyfully, O Israel. Be glad and exult with all your heart, O daughter Jerusalem. The Lord has removed the judgment against you. He has turned away your enemies. The King of Israel, the Lord, is in your midst. You have no further misfortune to fear. On that day, it shall be said to Jerusalem, fear not, O Zion, be not discouraged. The Lord, your God, is in your midst, a mighty Savior. He will rejoice over you with gladness and renew you in his love. He will sing joyfully because of you, as one sings at festivals. The word of the Lord. The response will be, the Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. In verdant pastures, he gives me repose. Beside restful waters, he leads me. He refreshes my soul. The Lord is my shepherd. He guides me in right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk in the dark valley, I fear no evil, for you are at my side, with your rod and your staff that give me courage. You spread the table before me in the sight of my foes. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Only goodness and kindness follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord for years to come. A reading from the book of Revelation. I saw a new heaven and a new earth. I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, behold, God's dwelling is with the human race. He will dwell with them and they will be his people, and God himself will always be with them as their God. He will wipe every tear from their eyes, and there shall be no more death or mourning, wailing or pain. for the old order has passed away. The one who sat on the throne said, Behold, I make all things new. The word of the Lord.
Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. It was now about noon, and darkness came over the whole land until 3 p.m, because of an eclipse of the sun. Then the veil of the temple was torn down the middle. Jesus cried out in a loud voice, Father, into your hands I commend my spirit. And when he had said this, he breathed his last. The centurion who witnessed what had happened glorified God and said, This man was innocent beyond doubt. When all the people who had gathered for this spectacle saw what had happened, they returned home beating their breasts. But all his acquaintances stood at a distance, including the women who had followed him from Galilee and saw these events. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord.
We are in these last few weeks of the Lenten season. It's good for us to focus upon this particular gospel reading, which tells us of the events that we will walk through next week, the passion, the suffering of Jesus as he hangs upon the cross. In this particular gospel reading, I like the description where it says, all his acquaintances, after Jesus has breathed his last, they continue to stand at a distance, including the women who had followed him from Galilee and saw these events. They stand there, I assume, in many ways crushed by what has happened. They had placed so much hope in the person of Jesus, so much promise was there, and it felt, I'm sure, like it was all lost, but they still stood there, I think somehow still hoping, not yet comprehending what would happen at the resurrection. But they were still hoping for something that would be revealed to them, because this person, Jesus, had come to be so central in their life. And of course, with the resurrection, everything changed. Where they were in such a dark place of despair, now they are filled with complete hope and joy in the promise that the resurrection has for all of us, for Inez today. We celebrate her life today, Inez's dedication to you as a family, the way she was there as a mother and a grandmother and a great-grandmother, the way she cared for you, the way she loved you and took care of you through the good times and the bad. You could say she stood at a distance in your lives, continuing to be there for you whenever you needed her help and her assistance. And of course, her years of dedication, first to Dr. Paulus, and then eventually through some other doctors went to Dr. Jensen in the end, until she was 77 years old. I find that remarkable. She worked for a long time in affecting a lot of people through her job there, touching a lot of people's lives as she took care of them as they would come into the office. Today, as we celebrate her life, we can see her as one of those believers, like all of us today, who gathered in this church. As believers, we all, in a sense, stand at a distance from these events of Jesus, trying to comprehend, and we walk through difficult times. Times when our hearts are very heavy and loaded, and where we feel despair, where we feel darkness, but we hold on. As we heard in the second reading, we know in the book of Revelation that God will create a new heaven and a new earth, where all the former things will pass away. Everything will be made new. And so as the prophet Zephaniah says in the first reading, rejoice, rejoice in the Lord, rejoice in the promises that are given to us. Shout for joy, O daughter Israel. That's what we can say today to Inez. Shout for joy, you who receive this promise of eternal life. You who are taken into the arms of God's mercy and love. The Lord has removed the judgment against you. On that day it shall be said, fear not, O Zion. Be not discouraged. Our hearts may be heavy as we have to say goodbye to Inez, but we can be filled with hope in the promise of resurrection. May God continue to lead us and guide us through these final days of the Lenten season to the Easter promises of resurrection. God blesses Inez today. May he bless each of us as we continue on our journey of faith. Stand for our intercession. Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church. Confident that God hears the prayers of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we join our prayers to his.
In baptism, Inez received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead her over the waters of death. We pray to the Lord. Our sister is nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome her into the halls of the heavenly banquet. We pray to the Lord. We are assembled here in faith and confidence to pray for Inez. Strengthen our hope so that we may live in the expectation of our son's coming. Pray to the Lord. Inez's family and friends seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain and dispel the darkness and doubt that come from grief. We pray to the Lord. For all of our deceased relatives and friends, especially the deceased of the Canny and Kasperbauer families, may they have the reward of their goodness. We pray to the Lord.
O God of loving kindness, listen favorably to our prayers. Strengthen our belief that your Son has risen from the dead, and our hope that your servant will also rise again. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated.
Thank you.
rights and yours may be acceptable to God, our Almighty God. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Inez, we beseech your mercy, that she who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the salvation of the world, life of the human race, the resurrection of the dead. Through him the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory.
Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest.
Please be seated. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. We Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Walker, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant Inez, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you to everyone who is here today to remember Inez Kasperbauer. This is going to be a tough one. I first met Inez the day I began practice in April of 1995. When I entered the building, everything was clean and organized, and I could tell right away she took pride in practice. She began every day by placing a warm cup of coffee upon my desk, and always with a good morning, Dr. Jensen. I soon grew to learn that Inez was more than capable of being a receptionist. She was perhaps the cornerstone of my fledgling practice. I learned over the years there was something about how at ease she made the patients feel when they walked through the door. Everyone seemed to know Inez, as she could speak to anybody. During this time, I realized that Inez knew about every single person in my practice, or that she was related to them. It wasn't always just a niece or nephew, it was a cousin or brother-in-law, or even a sister-in-law. In one conversation with her, I remarked that I think I'm the only one in town that you're not related to. It was then that I noticed she pursed her lips and her eyes widened and she said, "Well, you know Tim Worm." I said, "Well, of course, that's my sister Renee's boyfriend." I said with a chuckle. "Well," she said, "that's my nephew." And his mother is my sister. And at that moment, it was then right up that I realized, yes, Inez is related to everyone in town, somehow by blood or marriage to everyone in town. Over the years that I had the privilege to work with Inez, I discovered that she had a gift of gab, a soft heart, and a gentle soul. She had an air of confidence about her that she could set the most nervous at ease and make a complicated situation very simple. I knew if I was running late, returning from surgery or another busy clinic, Inez would have the waiting patient feel at home. She could make them comfortable, entertain them with a story or two. One of the things I remember most was that when the clinic began computer scheduling. You see, originally, she kept a notebook with all the appointments, and everything was handwritten. But she kept it organized in her own simple way. I knew she was smart and a capable person. She had a quick wit and very much enjoyed working in the clinic. And I knew it would break her heart if she had to retire before her time. The day came and the computers were placed at everyone's desk. For the next morning, it was computer training time. She came into my office with a nervous look on her face, something I'll never forget. She said, "Dr. Jensen, I don't think I can do this." And a tear came to her eye. She asked if she could retire right then and there. I looked at her, and I could see she wasn't ready to quit working. And I asked her not to be intimidated by that little box. I told her that she was very capable of learning to operate that computer. I said, "Come back tomorrow, at least try. The instructors are there to help you, and you can learn how to do this." I said, "Please try. And if after the first session you are overwhelmed, and you don't think you can do this, we'll find something else for you to do in the clinic. But I need you as my nurse." The next day came, and Inez showed. By noon, I went to the training area, and I saw Inez at one of the training desks, sitting in front of the computer, And I asked, well, how's it going? It was then and there that I knew Inez was not ready to retire, as she had the biggest smile on her face I'd ever seen. I think I can do this, she said, and the grin did not leave her face. Well, I said, that's good, because I didn't get you any retirement bonus. She had a good laugh and walked over and gave me a hug and said, thanks, Dr. Jensen, for believing me. Inez was a hard worker, but she enjoyed having fun. She would tell me about her bowling trips and spending time with her kids and grandkids. But the trips I found most interesting were the weekend getaways to the casinos. She was one of the luckiest ballroom bandit operators I knew. And it seems she always came home with them. Inez did not sit still and was always having fun. Inez had a kind and loving heart and a gentle soul. She was full of life and touched everyone she knew. She will be missed, and I will miss her too. My condolences and prayers are for her family and friends, and she rests in peace. Thank you.
God of endless ages, from one generation to the next, you have been our refuge and our strength. Before the mountains were born or the earth came to be, you are God. Have mercy now on your servant Inez, whose long life was spent in your service. Give her a place in your kingdom where hope is firm for all who love, and rest is sure for all who serve. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
On behalf of the family, I do want to extend an invitation to all of you to join them for the luncheon, which will be served at the Moose Lodge immediately after the burial in the cemetery. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself.
I love to see your face to face, to see with my own eyes.
your servant. In the sight of this world, she is now dead. In your sight, may she live forever. Forgive whatever sin she may have committed through human weakness, and in your goodness, grant her everlasting peace. Through Christ our Lord. In peace, let us now take our sister to her place of rest.